This presentation is to accompany the book Consumer Behavior, A Primer by Gail Thom. When you buy products, say a car or shoes, or pick a restaurant for dinner, what do you look for? What are important characteristics to you? How well do the various alternatives compare on these characteristics? These types of questions form the basis of the multi-attribute model of attitude. The multi-attribute model of attitude posits that consumers form attitudes towards products by evaluating them on selected product attributes or characteristics. Marketers want to show that their brand rates favorably on product attributes that are important to consumers. Take this advertisement for Quaker Oats, for example. The product attributes are sugar, additive, fiber, etc. And Quaker Oats rates favorably on all these attributes. Of course, these particular attributes were selected by the marketers, presumably because they are important to the consumers and because Quaker Oats rates well on them. This ad hopes to lead consumers to a positive attitude towards Quaker Oats. Clearly, the Kia rates favorably on all the important characteristics, especially affordability. There is only one characteristic on which the Kia does not rate well, but it's a minor point. In this ad for JCPenney's, we see that the JCPenney coat rates better than the competitor on all but one attribute. It's not surprising that this one attribute is not important. The JCPenney coat rates better than the competitor coat on all the other attributes, which are important. Consumers are led to form a more positive attitude to the JCPenney coat. This is an older advertisement, but it's still a good illustration of the multi-attribute attitude model. The marketer is comparing the Chrysler LeBaron GT to three cars, Audi, BMW, and Mercedes, on three product attributes, acceleration, cornering, sticker price. The Chrysler LeBaron rates the best on all three attributes. Consumers are led to form a more positive attitude towards the LeBaron than the other three competitors. We see an illustration of the multi-attribute attitude model in a more recent advertising campaign for Chevy. Here the Chevy Traverse is compared to the Honda Pilot, Toyota Highlander V6, Ford Flex on selected product attributes. Let's take a look at one of the TV ads.
If Toyota gets credit for being the most fuel-efficient car company in America, well, then how do you explain all this? Chevy Malibu, Cobalt, Silverado, and the all-new Equinox. Compare them to anyone. May the best car win.
The multi-attribute model of attitude can also be used diagnostically to understand not only whether consumers have a positive or negative attitude towards a brand, but why consumers have a positive or negative attitude. Say, for example, marketers find that consumers' attitude towards their brand is weak because the brand rates poorly on a product attribute that is important to consumers. One strategy is to turn a negative attribute into a positive one. As an example, let's take Guinness beer. When you drink a Guinness, you pour Guinness into a glass until it becomes about 3/4 full, and then you have to wait and wait and wait some more for 2 minutes until the foamy head settles, and then you can top it off. Consumers do not like to have to wait for the head of the beer to settle, and sales plummeted. Understand the reason for the poor attitude and resultant dip in sales, a marketing strategy was adopted, turning a negative, the long wait, into a positive. Guinness rolled out advertising campaigns like Good Things Come to Those Who Wait, and It Takes 119.53 seconds to pour out the perfect pint. Today, the ritual of the slow pour is part of the pleasure of drinking a Guinness.
Thank you.
This coaster was made for the Guinness tagline. When the coaster is placed on the table, the text on it is unreadable. When the glass is placed on it, it's still unreadable. But when the beer is poured in the glass, you can read the text perfectly in the reflection of the glass. And it reads, "Good things come to those who wait." This ad proclaims that Guinness is worth waiting for, just like Albert Einstein's long wait for a moment of discovery. Another strategy is to capitalize on a positive attribute. Reebok is superior to Nike on a critical attribute. In this ad from the 1980s, Reebok told the world why it was better than their competitor, Nike.
The Pump from Reebok. It fits a little better than your ordinary athletic shoe.